But one of us has to do something.
I said no. No adventures, no theatrics, no thief chasing.
Well, what are you going to do then, huh? Let's hear it.
We are done talking. About
maybe you could talk some sense into my pig-headed brother.
Yeah, well, I don't know what you overheard, but the Riverwood Trader is still open. Feel free to shop. We did have a bit of a break-in, but we still have plenty to sell. Robbers were only after one thing. An ornament, solid gold in the shape of a dragon's claw. You could? I've got some coin coming in from my last shipment. It's yours if you bring my claw back. Now, if you're going to get those thieves, you should head to Bleak Falls Barren.
So this is your plan, Lucan?
Yes. So now you don't have to go, do you?
Oh, really? Well, I think your new helper here needs a guide.
By the eight, fine. But only to the edge of town. Show those thieves not to steal from Luke and Valerius. Till next time.
We have to go through town and across the bridge to get to Bleak Falls Barrow. You can see it from here, though. The mountain just over the buildings. Those thieves must be mad hiding out there. Those old crypts are filled with nothing but traps, trolls, and who knows what else. I wonder why they only stole Lucan's golden claw. I mean, we have plenty of things in the shop that are worth just as much coin. Lucan found the claw about a year after he opened the store. He never quite explained where he got it. He's a tricky one. This is the bridge out of town. The path up the mountain to the northwest leads to Bleak Falls Barrow. I guess I should get back to my brother. He'll throw a fit if I take too long. Such a child. Mara bless you for agreeing to help us. Well, it's a winding road up the mountain just ahead. You'll know you're in the right place once you spot the old watchtower. Once you get to the tower, head north. Bleak Falls Barrow should be just around the corner further up. Good luck. Lucan and I will be waiting for you back in the shop.
You're kind of fuzzy. What's wrong with you? Got any ale or mead?
Orgnar, are you listening?
Hard not to.
The ale is going bad. We need to get a new batch. Did you hear me?
Yep, ale's going bad.
I guess you don't have potatoes in your ears after all. Just make sure we get a fresh batch in soon.
You're that visitor been poking around. Word is Ulfric Stormcloak escaped from the Imperials. War is only going to get worse now.
We got rooms and food. Drink, too. I cook. Ain't much else to tell. Need a room? Talk to Delphine. Long as you clean up, you know how to use it, right? Mix a couple of ingredients together, see what happens. A little wheat and blister wort makes a healing potion, if you didn't know. We have plenty of ingredients for sale, too. There have been whispers. A boy up in Windhelm, name of Aventus Aretino, been trying to contact the Dark Brotherhood. Looking to blow yourself up? I hear that's what magic does to you. There's a college in Winterhold that teaches magic, unless that blew up too. Be a lot safer just to have the Jarl's wizard
this
teach
a
you
local
a thing
favorite
or two.
And one of the first songs I ever learned. Ragnar the Red. Oh, there once
have you
was
seen that shrine of Azura?
The
they say the Dark the Elves built it after they fled from Morrowind. Sight to see.
And the braggart did swagger and brandish his blade as he
we've got something of a love triangle here in Riverwood. Faendal and Sven, both vying for
but
Camilla's affections.
He met the shield maiden Matilda.
Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter.
You talk and you lie and you drink all our mead. Now I think it's
word is, Ulfric Stormcloak escaped from the Imperials. War's only gonna get worse now. Drink for the thirsty, food for the hungry.
When his ugly red head rolled around on the floor. This is a local favorite and one of the first songs I ever learned. Ragnar the Red. Oh, there once was a hero named Ragnar the Red who came riding to Whiterun from old Rorik's stead. And the braggart did swagger and brandish his blade as he told of bold battles and gold he had made. But then he went quiet, did Ragnar the Red, when he met the Shield Maiden Matilda, who said, "Oh, you talk and you lie and you drink all our mead. Now I think it's high time that you lie down and bleed." And so then came clashing and slashing of steel as the brave lass Matilda charged in full of zeal. And the braggart named Ragnar was boastful no more when his ugly red head rolled around on the floor.
"We need a room? Talk to Delphine. Drink for the thirsty, food for the hungry." Mm-hmm.
Feyndahl thinks he can woo Camilla Valerius away from me. She's already mine, I keep telling him. At the Bard's College in Solitude, they train bards and scalds like myself. If you go there, talk to Viarmo. He's the headmaster. Lucan's got a little bit of everything at the Riverwood Trader. If you need weapons or armor, see Alvor, the blacksmith. Camilla Valerius knows I'm the best man in Riverwood. That elf is kidding himself if he thinks she would choose him over me. I've seen him sneaking over to the Riverwood Trader to speak with her when I'm not around. He's wasting his time. Is that sarcasm? I've heard better wisecracks from Orgnar. Ugh, still, you have a point. Camilla letting Feyndahl visit her isn't a good thing for me. Here, let me give you a particularly venomous letter. Say it's from Feyndahl. That should get Camilla to stop inviting the elf over. Truly? So maybe my mother isn't crazy after all.
You had best tell the Jarl in Whiterun. He needs to know about this.
Sure. What can I do for you? Only true Imperials request that one.
"We drink to our youth, to days come and gone, for the age of aggression is just about done. We'll drive out the storm cloaks and restore what we own. With our blood and our steel, we will take back our home. Down with Ulfric, the killer of kings. On the day of your death, we will drink and we'll sing. We're the children of Skyrim, and we fight all our lives. And when Sovngarde beckons, every one of us dies. But this land is ours, and we'll see it wiped clean of the scourge that has sullied our hopes and our dreams."
You look like a traveler. Someone that has seen faraway places and heard new stories. Sure. What can I do for you?
Ah, a fine but bloody tale. I can do that one.
This is a local favorite and one of the first songs I ever learned. Ragnar the Red.
"Oh, there once was a hero named Ragnar the Red, who came riding to Whiterun from old Rorik's stead. And the braggart did swagger and brandish his blade as he told of bold battles and gold he had made. But then he went quiet, did Ragnar the Red, when he met the Shield Maiden Matilda, who said, 'Oh, you talk and you lie and you drink all our mead. Now I think it's high time that you lie down and bleed.' And so then came clashing and slashing of steel as the brave lass Matilda charged in full of zeal. And the braggart named Ragnar was boastful no more when his ugly red head rolled around on the floor.
Thank you.
my favorite drinking buddy. Let's get some mead.
The sooner you find the claw, the sooner our lives can get back to normal.
I think I have a few old spell books laying about. If you want more, you'll have to go to the College of Winterhold. Till next time.
Nobody believes me, but I tell you, I saw a dragon.
Every day we get visitors in Riverwood. Whatever you need, buy you smear. If it's simple and strong, I can forge it. Gerda's family first settled here as woodcutters a few generations ago. She and Hod run the mill. I make a decent living sharpening axes and fixing the sawmill. I see no harm in it. If you have the skill. The grindstone will improve your weapons. Use the table to improve your armor. If you've got the raw materials, you can use the forge to make something new. Yes, actually. How about you smith me an iron dagger? Here's everything you need to make one. Go ahead. Good day. Looking for a new blade? Not bad, but it's a little dull. How about you sharpen it up? Just need a bit of metal and the grindstone over there. Mm-hmm. iron or steel is what you need. Leave that fancy elven stuff to the elves.
This looks good. You put time into your blades. They'll serve you well when you need them. You want to keep helping? How about you make some armor? Let's start by tanning some leather on the rack. All right, then. You the sneaky type? Got some nice daggers around here somewhere. Ah, good. A lot of weapons and armor need leather for straps, fittings, that kind of thing. Let's see if you can make a hide helmet. Here's the rest of what you need. All right, then. You looking for a new blade? I should hire you to be my assistant at this rate. Let's improve the fit. Take this leather to the workbench over there. Until next time. Iron or steel is what you need. Leave that fancy elven stuff to the elves. You have talent. Keep working at your craft, and you'll be a fine smith one day. Why don't you keep that dagger and helmet? Maybe you'll remember me when you're making Skyforge steel, huh? Take a look. I could forge you a warhammer that would crush a giant head like a walnut. Whatever you need. By Ysmir, if it's simple and strong, I can forge it. Blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs. And
Till next time. Looking for a new blade?
Some rest. The shift is coming up, and I don't want you dozing off again like last time. bad time to get lost, friend.
That it? At your best? That's all you've got?
You can't hide from me.
Can't wait to count out your coin.
We had a guard posted outside. Standing guard out there. Don't forget the rock trap we rigged up. So, stop your worrying and get some rest. Your shift is coming up and I don't want you dozing off again like last time.
God, no!
Huh?
Not the best you can do?
Found you. Thank you.
Someone there?
What was that?
That's all you've got?
sooner you find the claw, the sooner our lives can get back to normal. Take a look. Till next time.
This is an ode to Skyrim's staunch protectors, the Imperials. We drink to our youth, to days come and gone, for the age of aggression is just about done. We'll drive out the Stormcloaks and restore what we own. With our blood and our steel, we will take back our home. Down with Ulfric, the killer of kings. On the day of your death, we will drink and we'll sing. We're the children of Skyrim, and we fight all our lives. And when Sovngarde beckons, every one of us dies. But this land is ours, and we'll see it wiped clean of the scourge that has sullied our hopes and our dreams.
You're that visitor been poking around. Sure thing. It's yours for a day. Are you joking? You just rented a room from me. They say a dragon attacked Helgen. Sounds like hogwash to me.
Give me a mug of ale.
Coming right up.